Hello friends, you're watching edurythms coaching classes and I'm your host and friend Dr. Zubair Shalibhat. Today I'm going to talk about CSIR-NET-JRF life sciences. Friends, it's an exam which every aspirant who wants to do a PhD has to go through. It is taken twice offline, twice in a year, in the month of June and December. But most of the students are afraid of it. What's the reason of this? The reason is this exam is not like just another exam. It is a very unique exam where they test your basic knowledge, they test your basic concepts, and then they test your ability to apply those concepts. Now, the very important question that stands is how to prepare for CSIR-NET-JRF in life sciences. Welcome to edurythms coaching classes biology, where we add rhythm to your preparation. Yes friends, your preparation. If you are an aspirant of CSIR-NET-JRF in life sciences, then this video is for you. So the question stands, how to prepare for CSIR-NET-JRF? In this case, when you look at the syllabus, you have 13 units. But when you look on from the concept point of view, you'll find that the syllabus is not in a systematic manner. But anyhow, you have to prepare according to the syllabus only. There's no choice. Talking about how to prepare for it. So the first thing that you need to know is that your basics should be very strong. Number one, so how can you build your basics? Point number two, you can build them by selecting a very good textbook. A textbook which you can revise many times over. Point number three is once you start reading the text, you understand the concepts, you may need a help of a tutor. That's where my role comes in. Or any other person who is teaching for CSIR-NET-JRF. Point number four is once your concepts are clear, now what you need to do is you need to make your notes. So how do you make your notes? The notes when you read, you have to prepare them of your own, in your own handwriting, so that when the exam comes, you can revise very quickly. So how to prepare the notes? The notes you can prepare not by writing all stuff what is in the textbook, but by making tables, flowcharts, diagrams, and any other mnemonics you can learn so that you can revise or you can recall the concept when you are appearing for the test. Now this test comes in three different formats. Paper A, Paper B, and Paper C. The format is all the same, that is MCQ, but the level of difficulty is different. That's what you have to deal with. So once you choose your 8 units out of total 13, what you need to do is you need to go the extra step. And that extra step is to do something else. Step away or step ahead of your field. That is, you can, if you are a biotechnologist, you can choose evolution, ecology. These are very good because they're classical topics, so the questions don't vary too much. You can attempt those and that gives you an extra edge. Thank you very much.